number 86, question number 8. Write journal entries for Krishna for the following transaction. First, give the heading. Journal entry of Krishna. Settle down. Now, first transaction is 2014 March 1. So, 2014 March 1. 20,000 deposited with bank and opened account. What goes out? Cash. Who is the receiver? Bank is the receiver. So, bank account debit. 20,000 to cash account, 20,000, open bank account by depositing cash. Close it. Next, March 5th, a check of 5,000 received from Hari, which immediately deposited with the bank. Now we received a check, we deposited the check in the bank. So who is the receiver? Bank is the receiver. So bank account debit, transaction number 5. A bank account debit 5,000 to what? To what? Who is the giver of this check? Hari. To Hari account 5,000 being received check from Hari. Deposited. Practically, when we receive a check, in the narration we also mention kaun si bank ka check hai, kaun sa check number hai, kaun se branch ka check. Okay? Practically, this is what we do. So that if any time the check is dishonored, we want to see ki isne kaun sa check diya tha, toh we can directly get from this journal entry. Next. Transaction number 6. A check of 2,000 received from Ramnik Lal for dues. Now, again we received a check. So, check is going to be deposited in the bank. Nothing is given, so it is assumed that it has gone into the bank. So, bank account debit. 2,000. To Ramnik Lal account, 2,000. Name check received from Ramnik Lal. Goods sold to Rupali 14,000, out of which check received for half the amount, which is deposited in the bank. Mark this important, it's a new transaction for you. Now, you sold goods of 14,000 to Rupali. Now, sabse pehle, you are able to make the first effect that goods goes out. So, sales account will be credited by 14,000. Kitne ka check mila? Kitne ka check mila? 7,000, jo humne jaake bank mein deposit kar diya. So, very important, bank account debit. Bank is the receiver for 7,000 ka check. Now, out of 14,000, we received 7,000. How much we have to still receive from Rupali? 7,000. So now we have to record the name Rupali. because 7,000 we have to still recover from Rupali. So bank account debit 7,000, Rupali account debit 7,000. To goods goes out. So to sales account 14. Understood this, all of you? ये नाम क्यों रिकॉर्ड किया पता चल गया? नाम रिकॉर्ड करेंगे उतने ही अमाउंट का जितना अमाउंट अभी हमें और लेना बाकी है. Understood this? Being goods sold to Rupali. And receive check for half amount. Yes, we are selling goods of 40,000 to Rupali. So goods goes out, sales account credit 40,000. We received a check of 7,000. We deposited in the bank. So bank account debit by 7,000. How much we have to still receive from Rupali?
7,000.
So we debit. Rupali is the receiver. In accounts, we record name of a person only if we have to receive money or if we have to pay money. Or if we had to receive in past and we are receiving now, or we had to pay in past, we are paying now. In that case only we will record the names. Otherwise, we don't have to record the. Understood this? Okay. Next one. Similar to 10, goods of 10,000 purchased from Deep Kala and paid half amount by check. Can we make the entry out of this? What will be the entry? First effect kya aega? Purchase account debit. How much? How much purchase account debit? 10,000. Two. Bank account credit how much?
5,000.
And to Deep Kala account credit?
5,000.
Understood this, all of you? Okay. So purchase account debit 10,000, goods comes in. We gave a check. So bank account credit 5,000. And to we have to still pay. Abhi paisa dena baki hai. 10,000 ka goods kharida. उसमें से वी पेड ओनली 5,000. 5,000 येट टू बी पेड टू हूम? टू द गिवर ऑफ गुड्स. हु इज द गिवर? दीप कला इज द गिवर. बी परचेज गुड्स फ्रॉम दीप कला एंड पेड half amount by check. Fifteenth is a very important transaction. Please mark 15th as an important transaction. 400. Yeah, though, please. Very important transaction. 400 withdrawn from bank for personal expense and 800 for office expense. It means we went to the bank, we withdrew 400 for personal expense and we withdrew 800 for office expense. So 400 jo hai wo owner leke apne ghar chala gaya. So that is known as what?
Drawings.
800, have we incurred office expense or we have just taken cash in the business?
We have just taken cash in the business
ke cash box mein hum 800 rupees rakh denge. Now when you are withdrawing for personal use, which account we debit? Drawings. Owner is the receiver. Drawings account debit 400. Then you withdrew for office expense. So second effect, office expense account debit or cash account?
Cash.
Because abhi tak office expense incur kiya nahi hai. So cash account debit 800. Who is the giver? Bank is the giver. Credit the giver. be withdrew from bank for office and personal expense. Are you able to visualize this?
Yes.
तुम बैंक में गए, तुमने 1200 विड्रॉ किया, उसमें से 400 तुम घर ले गए, तो बिजनेस में रिकॉर्ड हो जाएगा कि बैंक से पैसा गया, अकाउंट लेके गया, ओनर लेके गया. So drawings, owner is the receiver, debit the receiver. बाकी का पैसा हमने बिजनेस के कैश बॉक्स में रखा ऑफिस एक्सपेंस के लिए. तो बिजनेस के लिए व्हाट कम्स इन? कैश कम्स इन. ओके, नेक्स्ट 18, मार्केट इंपोर्टेड अगेन. ऑल दीज विल डेफिनेटली कम इन योर एग्जाम एज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ फुल फ्लेज्ड सम. लाइफ इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम 300 and fire insurance premium 450 paid by check. Now life insurance premium kiska life?
Owner.
So it is known as
drawings.
Owner is the receiver. Or fire insurance premium, personal expense or business expense?
Business
expense. So we record drawings account debit. Amount is 300. Fire insurance premium account debit. Amount is 450. Two. कहाँ से गया पैसा? We paid by
check.
So who is the giver? Bank is the giver. 750. All of you understood this transaction? In exam, if you write life insurance premium account debit, fire insurance premium account debit, your answer goes wrong. Life insurance is for the owner. Owner is the receiver. Got it, all of you? Very important. Being paid life insurance premium. And fire insurance premium by check. We know the 20th transaction. Bank has approved. यानि bank ने सिर्फ approve किया है overdraft of 25,000. So we have to write 20th non-economic transaction. 25th, again important. We have done this before. Bank has credited interest of 250 and debited bank charges of rupees 100. Now bank has credited interest, so bank balance increase or bank balance decrease?
Increase.
Bank balance increase. Whenever bank balance increase, bank is the receiver. Debit the receiver. Bank account debit 250. क्या मिला हमें बैंक में? बैलेंस क्यों बढ़ा? Why did the balance increase? Because we got interest. So interest is our income. To bank interest account 250. Naresh, being bank credited interest. Yes. अलग से, बिकॉज हम उसको कंबाइन नहीं कर सकते. यू पास अ सेपरेट एंट्री फॉर्म. वी कैन नॉट कंबाइन बोथ. ओके, वी पास अ सेपरेट एंट्री. नाउ ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, बैंक क्रेडिटेड यानी बैंक कलेक्टेड, सो बैंक बैलेंस इंक्रीज. नाउ बैंक डेबिटेड, बैंक चार्जेस, सो बैंक डेबिटेड यानी बैंक डिडक्टेड, सो बैंक बैलेंस डिक्रीज. Now bank balance decrease, bank is the giver, credit the giver. Debit किसको करेंगे? Debit किसको करेंगे? Bank charges को, वो हमारा expense है. समझ में आया? Bank debited, bank charges, याने bank ने हमारे account से, for example, तुम्हारे prepaid account में से prepaid balance, mobile का जो balance है उसमें से 25 rupees caller tune deduct हो गया. You understood this क्या हुआ? तुम्हारा 100 rupees का balance था, तुमने एक caller tune activate कराया, तो वो 100 became 75. So your balance decreased. At the same time, can I say खर्चा हुआ? Expense हुआ, okay? So over here, bank charges account debit to bank account. What's the amount?
100.
You understood the two effects? Bank balance decrease and bank charges expense income. खर्चा हुआ हमारा, इसके लिए बैंक ने हमें सर्विस दिया, उसके लिए बैंक ने हमसे चार्जेस कलेक्ट किया. सो सर्विस कम्स इन, बैंक बैलेंस डिक्रीज, सो बैंक इज द गिवर. बी, बैंक डेबिटेड, बैंक चार्जेस. Next, 31st, a check of 5,000 issued for foreign visit of son of owner from the business. What is this? Business expense or personal expense? Personal expense. So it is drawings. Drawings account debit. To bank account 5,000 being paid by check for son's foreign travel. Do the totals. Foreign trip or foreign travel. What's the importance of total is, ये जो total है, उसमें we are writing this debit total and credit total to see if we have recorded debit is equal to credit. In exam, if your total does not match with total of your friend, it doesn't mean you are wrong or that person is wrong. This has to be equal. Understood this? Because many times we combine entry, we write separate entry, so total may be different, but this total has only importance that it should always be equal. Understood this? Okay. Format for the next of question number 7, transactions for loan and interest. Write the following transaction in the journal of Pushkar. So heading there is a journal entry. Journal entry 2014 February 1, due to additional requirements of funds, 12% loan of 20,000 borrowed from now. So what comes in?
Cash.
Cash comes in. Cash account debit 20,000. 2. Who is the giver? Ram is the giver. But name of the account will be 12% Ram's loan account. 20,000 being loan taken from Ram at the rate 12%. Now what is this 12%?
Interest.
12% is interest per year. Okay. Next, 3,000 lent to Lakshman at interest rate of 8%. So what goes out?
Cash
goes out. Who is the receiver? Lakshman is the receiver. So we write 8%. We are giving loan. Lakshman's loan account? 8,000. To cash. Cash goes out. Credit bond goes out. Being lent loan to Lakshman at the rate 8%. Now, 8th is a tricky one. Please, dhyan dena. Receive cash 800 for loan lent to Bharat and 200 for interest. So, how much total cash we are receiving? 1,000. So, cash account debit. Please, dhyan do. Aisa to baad mein likhna. Cash account debit 1,000. Now, 2. Against loan. How much हमने किसी को लोन दिया था उसमें से 800 वापस आया. Whenever we had given a loan, we would have debited loan account. Now when we are receiving that money, we will credit loan account. Understood this?
Yes.
No. Once again, when you give a loan, cash goes out and Bharat was the receiver, debit the receiver. Now cash comes in. Who is the giver? Bharat is the giver. Credit the given. You understood this now? So, cash account debit to Bharat's loan account. Credit. Loan ke saamne kitna paisa? Only 800. Understood this? Remaining kya mil raha hai hume? Interest, which is our income. Okay, so 2. Interest on Bharat's loan. Account 200. If you write cash to Bharat's loan 1,000, it is wrong because you are getting 800 towards loan and 200 towards interest. So interest tumhara income hai. That's why we credit interest. Loan Bharat is the giver, so credit the giver. And how much cash comes in? 1,000 cash comes in. Understood all of you? Okay, write the narration. Being received. Cash for loan of Bharat with interest. Next, receive. Should I proceed now? Okay, next is 8th one. 5,000 returned back to Sita for borrowed loan. It means we had taken loan of 5,000 from Sita. So we are giving back that 5,000. Plus what we are giving back? We are giving interest of rupees 400. So when we are giving loan back to Sita, Sita is the receiver. Debit the receiver. Sita's loan account debit. 5,000. Now, you took a loan of 5,000. You are giving 400 as interest. So, interest is our expense. Interest on Sita's loan account. Debit 400 to cash account. 5,000. You want me to repeat this?
Yes.
Achha. You want me to repeat the previous one? Ki wo pata chal gaya. Nahin, main pehla wala bhi repeat karta hun. See, 5,000 received cash 800 for loan lent to Bharat and 200 for interest. Pehle ye transaction ka matlab samjhata hun. Ki humne pehle Bharat ko 800 rupees loan mein diya tha. Say for example, tumne 800 rupees Bharat ko loan mein diya. Now, tum usse wapas kya loge? Tum loan to wapas maangoge. Plus तुम बोलोगे मुझे interest भी चाहिए क्योंकि you have used my money for 1 month, 2 month, 3 month. Now Bharat is giving us rupees 1,000, so 1,000 cash comes in. That is understood by all. Now 800 what you are getting from Bharat was towards his loan. So who is the giver? Bharat is the giver. Credit the giver. But we will not just write the name Bharat. We will write Bharat's loan account. Got it? You understood this? Plus we are getting rupees 200 as interest. Can I say 800 diya? 1000 mila. So 200 ka fayda hua, profit hua, income hua. So interest account credit 200. Which rule we use over your interest account? Rule of nominal account. Debit the expenses and losses. Credit the income, gains and profit. Pura accounts ye teen rule pe hi hai. Now, iske baad. Next, ye pata chal gaya abhi sabko. Next, 5000 returned back to Sita. Ab tumne kisi se loan liya 5000 ka. तो पहली बात तो तुम वो 5000 का लोन वापस कर रहे हो. अब लोन के साथ साथ तुम्हें एक्स्ट्रा क्या देना पड़ रहा है? इंटरेस्ट देना पड़ रहा है. तो कहने से इंटरेस्ट अब तुम्हारा एक्सपेंस है. लिया 5000 पर देना पड़ रहा है 5400. सो सीता इज द रिसीवर. 5000 इंटरेस्ट एक्सपेंस इनकर्ड 400 एंड कैश गोज आउट 5400. अंडरस्टूड दिस नाउ? ओके. Narration likho. Being returned Sita's loan with interest. Both these transactions important. Is a very simple one. Received interest 200 for loan lent to Kaushal. Now you received 200 as interest. So what comes in? Cash. And credit kisko karenge? Kaushal ko karenge ya interest ko karenge? Ab interest mila hai, received interest. To naam record karne ki zarurat hai Kaushal. Cash mila. Or income on service goes out. Understood this? Yahan pe naam record karne ki zarurat nahi hai. So received interest 200 for loan linked to Kaushal. We are receiving interest, so cash comes in and service goes out. Name of the service is interest. So interest income on. Write the entry. 12. Cash account debit. What's the amount? 200. 200 to interest on Kaushal's loan account. 200 B received interest on Kaushal's loan. Interest for one month paid for loan obtained from Ram. Now we have taken loan from Ram. Transaction number one may first Feb. We took a loan from Ram. Now we are paying interest for how much? For one month. You understood this? Now is the amount given? No. Amount is not given. So we have to calculate the amount. The word paid means cash goes out. So over here. See, we had taken a loan. Dhyan do. Yahan pe loan liya, humne cash comes in. Kitna loan liya? 20,000 ka. Ab uske upar hume interest dena pad raha hai. To interest hamara expense hai. Understood this? So interest on Ram's loan account debit. To what goes out? Cash goes out. But amount is not given. We have to calculate the amount. Do you know simple interest? PRN upon 100. Yaad aa gaya tumhe? What's the amount of loan? 20,000 into, what is the rate of interest? 12%, so 12 by 100 into how many months? Only 1 month. Only 1 month. So we write 1 upon 12. Yes, I know that. Amount will be 200. If you do it on calculator, directly 20,000 into 12% into 1 upon 12 or directly divide by 12. उससे भी सिंपल मेथड, कैलसी का भी जरूरत नहीं है. 12% पूरे साल का, यानी हर एक महीने का 1%. So directly 1% of 20,000, which is equal to 2. B. Interest paid on loan for 1 month. ध्यान देना प्लीज, 75 बिकेम रिसीवेबल. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिसीवेबल? रिसीवेबल यानी मुझे मिलना चाहिए पर अभी तक मिला नहीं है. 75 बिकेम रिसीवेबल फॉर इंटरेस्ट ऑन लोन ऑफ लक्ष्मण, यानी मुझे उसके पास से 75 रुपीज लेना है टुवर्ड्स इंटरेस्ट, जो अभी तक मिला नहीं है. बट आई हैव अ राइट टू रिकवर दिस मनी. रिकवर दिस मनी फ्रॉम हूम? फ्रॉम लक्ष्मण. ओके, नाउ टेल मी, इफ आई से माय इंटरेस्ट इज रिसीवेबल, तो इंटरेस्ट मेरा इनकम है या एक्सपेंस है?
इनकम
है, बिकॉज मैं कहता हूँ कि मुझे इतना पैसा इंटरेस्ट का किसी से लेना है. सो फर्स्ट इफेक्ट इज वेरी सिंपल, टू इंटरेस्ट ऑन लोन ऑफ लक्ष्मण अकाउंट क्रेडिट. व्हाट्स द अमाउंट? 75. नाउ हैव वी रिसीव्ड दिस इंटरेस्ट? अच्छा, दूसरा वे ऑफ डूइंग दिस, एक तो रिसीवेबल है यानी मुझे मिलना चाहिए, तो मैं कब बोल सकता हूँ मुझे मिलना चाहिए? जब मैंने सर्विसेज दिया है, तो कहने से मेरा इनकम है. मैं कब बोल सकता हूँ स्टूडेंट को कि मुझे मेरा फीस दो? जब उसने आके यहाँ पे एडमिशन लिया, ही स्टार्टेड स्टडी, तो आई से ये मेरा फीस मेरा इनकम है. समझ में आ रहा है? अब हो सकता है स्टूडेंट ने फीस दिया नहीं, तो कैन आई से वो फीस मेरे लिए रिसीवेबल है? आई हैव अ राइट टू रिकवर. मैं उसको फोन करके या उसको बोल सकता हूँ, पेरेंट्स को बोल सकता हूँ कि आप प्लीज फीस डिपॉजिट कर दो. अंडरस्टूड दिस? नाउ इंटरेस्ट ऑन लोन ऑफ लक्ष्मण इज माई इनकम, बट हैव आई रिसीव्ड द मनी? This amount is receivable, so we use the account interest receivable account. Now you may have a doubt, sir, why not name? Why we don't write name of Lakshman? Because we have given the service. Who is the receiver of this service or benefit? Lakshman, debit the receiver. But since it is related with income and expense, we don't write the name. We write interest receivable, salary payable, rent receivable, prepaid expense. We don't write the name. We write it this way. These accounts are personal account because they are related with person Lakshman, but we don't write the name. That's why these accounts are also known as representative personal accounts. That is why, because they represent a person, although name is not written. Pata chal raha hai sabko? Narration likho. B. Being interest on Lakshman's loan. This is your final total. Always you have to make sure that debit is equal to credit.